What's up, hams? Dylan Ham here. And today is gonna be sort of an experiment where I will be doing my first ASMR video, which is also short for autonomous sensory Meridian response. So video like this for quite a while, but I never really got around to doing it. But also because of I've been real caught up with my retail job, and also due to the plague. I mean, that was also another reason why I didn't really get enough time to get into these kind of videos. But I figured that due to the plague and everyone else freaking out about it and losing their minds, and just buying up toilet paper like there's no tomorrow, I figured that this would have been a good time to make this video to just calm people down, to ease their minds, and to help them relax. So, I've been watching ASMR since, let's say, late of 2019. Because it's a way to help you relax. And it's also a way to help, for people that may have insomnia. It's a way for people to help them get some sleep. Which, I'm still kind of sleepy, I'll admit, I am still kind of sleepy. Which is also another reason why I'm making this video. So, I have a few items here that I will be using, which we'll get into later on, but to start this video off, I'm gonna be using my bare hands here. So without further ado, let's begin. So, the first item that I will be using is a fidget spinner. So, I'll just spin it, and then I'll just move it, all around. Here we go. is an Xbox 360 controller. Unfortunately, I don't have my 360 anymore because it stopped working on me. Possibly due to the Red Ring of Death, which is the most notorious malfunction of the 360. Although I've kept it with me, the reason why I kept it with me all this time, well, not only because it still works, but I've also kept it with me, like, for PC gaming, or something like that, like PC gaming, because you can actually use a 360 controller to play on your PC, so that's quite a convenience. I'm gonna take this off first. Because I've still got batteries in here, and just so that way I don't, like, accidentally, like when I push this, so that way I don't end up, like, turning it on by accident. Which I don't know how it can, since I don't have my 360 console anymore. But anyway. Next, the PSP. It's a shame that Sony isn't gonna be making any more portable consoles. I mean, I just like the idea of bringing games on the go. Very, very unique concept. cheat code Superbook. Remember when they used to be a thing back in the day? Back before there was Netflix and all these other digital distribution platforms or services. This book is also really old, so as you can already tell, it's falling apart, and it's kind of like you can like it's and there's one page in this book that has been ripped off. So anyway, so I'll kind of read through it, and like I'm not gonna read through the whole book. I'll just read through certain things that I feel may be of interest, and that I may also like bring up. So there's the chapter. Here's the chapter and the list of all the video game consoles. And then here's a list of all the games on the current system. Where you can see where all the different codes for the games. But this was a way that we could look up cheat codes back before we had before. Well, now, whereas nowadays you can now just go on the internet and look up the game and just look up the cheat codes for the game that way. Whereas back then we had these. Find whatever game you were playing, and then depending on what console you were playing the game on, and then just find the cheat codes and codes that way. And one thing I also wanted to bring up, but yeah, that's the page I was talking about that was ripping apart. But this was also a way, like say that you play like GTA San Andreas. Back when I played this when I was a lot younger, I would look through several different cheats, and obviously there were many of the cheats would help you progress through the game, won't cheat your way through the game, while there were many other cheats that you could use to have even more fun with the game. Like cars fly, where you could actually fly in cars, like, which also kind of reminds me of Harry Potter in the Chamber of Secrets, where Harry and Ron have that flying car. That's what it reminds me of. And then what else have we got here? And then of course there's invisible vehicles. CJ is a clown, civilians and fast food apparel, and more. I also like that sheet a lot too. Pedestrians attack each other. Pedestrians carry weapons. These were the three cheats that I would do, like for people to go on a riot, and people to attack each other where they would attack you, and just many other things, like all these different codes you could use to have an even more fun experience with the game. And as a matter of fact, Jeff the Huntsman, back when we would spend the night with each other at each other's houses, we would have this cheat book every time when we popped in GTA San Andreas. have all these different sheets that we would use to have more fun experience. Have a more fun experience with the game, and it was just really interesting to see what all these different kinds of cheat codes would do, and what they, how they would affect the game. So many memories. So many good memories. And then, of course, there's Vice City. Okay, what else is there? I'm just looking through and just flipping through pages. Alright. Saints Row 2. One of my favorite games of all time. This game had some of the best cheats of all I've ever seen. Where you can activate evil cars where people or pedestrians and cars would try to run over you. And then there was the low gravity cheat, which was also a really fun cheat to use, especially like when you were playing insurance fraud and you had the low gravity cheat activated. It was a great way for you to go up in the air and to gain more money and just every other thing about it. That was so great about it. And then there's of course the world where you could activate super explosions and then pedestrian war, like kind of like in GTA San Andreas. You could make people go into a full-on riot. Drunk pedestrians, raining pedestrians, and then of course, like I said, low gravity, and then there's evil cars. This video. I'm really glad that I got the time to do this, because I have wanted to do an ASMR video for so long, but I never got around to doing it. But I'm glad I have now. So let me know down in the comments if you really liked this, and if you would like me, and if you want to see any more ASMR videos. Let me know down in the comments. And also, if you're new to the channel, be sure to hit the drop that like button, leave a comment below, subscribe to the channel to catch any upcoming videos in the near future, most importantly, to become a hand